Cardiac imaging refers to techniques for us to visualize the heart function and heart structure. And over time, these techniques have evolved and improved. For example, there was a time when we would take a standard X-ray of the chest and see the heart. But we don't do that today in our standard workup. We do utilize the electrocardiogram, EKG or ECG. It does provide us some electrical activity insights to the heart, but it can also provide some insights into cardiac structure in terms of a thick heart muscle, like hypertrophy, or if the heart has suffered a heart attack. Echocardiogram, so an echo for short, is probably our most utilized technique. It uses sound waves or ultrasound for us to image and visualize the heart. So basically we use a probe that pushes sound waves to the heart. It reflects off the heart and back to the probe for us to create and capture that image. And it gives us tremendous insight into heart function, valvular function, the sac around the heart, and how everything fits together. So it's a simple, portable, efficient technique that is free of radiation. Nuclear cardiac imaging involves the injection of a radioisotope into the system, very small doses. Those radioisotope emits gamma rays that a camera can then pick up and detect. We typically use this in stress testing, so fairly routine stress testing, a test we call a cardiolite, where we're able to look for blood flow differences across the heart muscle. Positron emission tomography, or PET for short, is a technique that also uses a radioisotope for us to basically label cells and evaluate metabolism. A very important tool that we use here at National Jewish in our patients with sarcoidosis to detect if there's any active sarcoid involvement of the heart.